While facing the Budget Committee to defend budget allocations for the Ministry of Defence, the Parliamentary Committee on Defence and Internal Affairs has asked Parliament to allocate 21.4 billion shillings for the UPDF operations in the Democratic Republic of Congo, codenamed Operation Shujaa.
Information not the Mosamba. Even when you read on in our report page 21, we are saying the committee recommends that UPDF are already deployed in DRC and they need support. Government should avail 21.4 billion required for funding for Operation Shujaa. However, government should brief Parliament and seek its sanction in accordance with the law.
However, the request faced tough resistance in the committee as majority members rejected the appropriation of money to an operation that has never been approved by Parliament.
Despite the incessant demands by Parliament to be informed or even endorse this operation Shujaa, it fell on deaf ears. Now, would it be procedurally okay for the committee to now remember that it is Parliament that has, and the ministry has done well not even to make an allocation here?
I mean, the supplementary they presented for Shujaa, we requested them that they refused to do the constitutional obligation of informing Parliament whenever there is need to deploy our army outside the country. They ignored Parliament. And in the process, we have a role to play as Parliament. The question is, why are they keeping coming, bringing matters to Parliament when they refused to inform the people of Uganda about Shujaa?
So we would follow the recommendation of the committee, which said, let the money be provided, but before it is approved, the government should come and explain how far we have gone, how long we need to be there, what is the level of success story.
The Committee on Defense has also recommended enhancement of salaries for lower-ranking UPDF officers who have been earning peanuts. MPs noted with concern that salaries of UPDF soldiers on private rank was last reviewed 8 years ago despite the prevailing inflation. 492 billion shillings is required for this item, but it has not been provided for.
Established that salaries for soldiers were last enhanced 8 years ago. The current monthly salary pay for a soldier at a private rank is 485,000 shillings.
With 3.7 trillion budget for defense in the financial year 2022-2023, the ministry is grappling with a budget shortfall of 87.5 billion shillings for salaries of local defense personnel who were recently absorbed by UPDF and some commissioned officers.
We all know that salary is a statutory obligation, and that's why we want Minister of Finance to provide funding for salaries for local defense forces, that is the LDPs, so that they can be catered for. You cannot even continue recruiting people that you are not providing for.
Yeah, actually, we realize the ministry has dispensed injustice to our soldiers and the men in uniform. We expected both internal and defense, internal affairs and the defense ministry to cater for an enhancement of salaries.
However, the budget committee members led by Muwanga Chivumbi put the Ministry of Defense on spot to clear outstanding arrears accrued from renting Buganda Kingdom properties in the next financial year. Chivumbi says defense owes Buganda Kingdom arrears amounting to 500 billion shillings.
Yes, Buganda over the years has been generous. So the government occupies many, many historical sites, things like Makindye Barracks, Mbuya Barracks, part of Mbuya Barracks, and other sensitive security installations are housed on Buganda land, and the government is supposed to be to pay rent. That it's now totaling 280 billion.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.